What do you think?
Okay, let's go with that. Bring her right in, okay?
She works magic with her eyes. Full of innocence that mesmerize. Standing before the camera, she smiles and woman smile. But under the makeup, there hides a child.
Just flown out to California. The limousine is waiting for you at the airport. You get in, and who's in the back seat?
Rod Stewart. No, Tim Hutton.
Whatever happened to Harrison Ford? Okay, Tim Hutton. And he's taking you straight to a Springsteen concert. Throw your head back now. Good. Hey, he's just told you this incredibly funny joke. Yes. Yeah. Out in California to see Brucey, the boss. He kisses you. You melt like chocolate chip in the sun. Great. Okay, where are you now?
The beach.
You run back to your towels. You collapse.
Good.
Goes around. Now look at him. Look at me. Give it to me.
All right.
Yeah, give it to you. Oh. All right. Beautiful, baby. Crazy. Oh, yes. What you were doing on the beach?
Rehearsing a scene. He wanted me for his next film.
Someday.
You think?
Well, if that's what you want, babe.
Someone please turn the heat up before I freeze my buns off.
What buns?
Give her time. Sooner or later, we all spread.
Annabelle, these pins are sticking to me.
Annabelle's heavy into voodoo, don't you know?
Wrong side of the bed this morning, Gary?
I think the Kenzo's hotter for the cover, don't you?
Uh-huh.
The Valentino, and tell him I want a park shoot on the sportswear tomorrow.
New face, Conrad.
Okay, dear. Easy. All yours.
Hey, congrats. You're gonna do Wesley's new collection. Now just watch out for his personal collection.
He's that bad?
Don't worry. We'll protect you.
Hairspray. Right in the eyes.
I'll just tell him to keep his hands off the merchandise.
Whoa, I didn't say blow the gig. I mean, we're talking biggest name in the biz, brightest talent.
Slimiest reptile.
True, but he sure knows how to sell it.
And that's where I come in, right?
You guys going to Kevin's party tonight?
If all else fails.
I'll drag him if I have to.
I want to go.
Well, then come with me.
Got homework. My stupid tutor is really laying it on. Anybody here good at high school algebra?
I can't even balance my checkbook.
It could be worse. Could actually have to go to high school.
Have the results of that algebra test. You said it. Homework assignment tonight, sections 11 through 14. You should be able to fit in about 4 problems per commercial. But I wouldn't recommend being stoned. Good work, Deb. You've done better. That's better than last time, Bill.
You think Mrs. Boone smokes grass?
Yeah, probably.
Hey, what do you think, Lori?
But Taryn Blake doesn't have to do algebra.
Lori Caswell, if I were you, I'd pay more attention to algebra and forget the magazines. Detention after school.
Yes, Mrs. Boone.
You guys, wait up! Wait. Hey, Lori, I will do your algebra if you buy me a Porsche.
Okay? Hold me up, I'm about to die.
Oh.
Hi, Eric.
Nice try, Kelly.
I don't blame her. He's beautiful.
Just because he's taller than you, don't start getting any ideas. Anyway, you got my brother.
What about your brother?
Hi, Steve.
Hello. I'll pick you up at 7, okay?
Okay.
Listen, tell Mom I'll be home after practice, and don't forget to feed the dog.
Yes, Master. God, if you guys ever get married, I sure hope you can afford a maid.
Really?
Hang this up, please.
Mom, it was my favorite scene.
You've only seen it 40 times. Now I want 1 hour of algebra, and then I want lights out at 10. You look tired this morning. Conrad had to use concealer. I won't be late. Give me the potato chips. Your mouth is filled with salt.
Have a good time.
With an account executive, I don't do this to have a good time. I do this for you. See you in the morning.
Cosine of x equals 2y plus z. Oh, help! Mom!
Hello.
Mom, you finished already?
Yeah. See, paying bills is easy when you don't have any money.
We're supposed to grow old together, you know.
Old and poor.
Old, poor, and fat.
Turning into a giant, I swear. What am I gonna wear to the concert tomorrow?
Well, maybe you can wear something in mine.
Your stuff's too short for me. Why am I so tall?
Oh, no, it's willowy.
Willowy? I'm a redwood.
Your father was tall. You got his jeans.
Maybe we could ask him to send me an extra pair.
Listen, I'm going into the city tomorrow, and if you can stand an hour or so at the Met, maybe we can go over to Bloomingdale's on the way home.
Really?
Well, I need an excuse.
You don't need an excuse. If I look like you, it wouldn't matter what I wore.
Bloomingdale's?
Really?
I think I sent him the minimum this month. Oh, come on now, stop with the mush. The ice cream's better.
Not for me, not if I'm going shopping tomorrow. Thanks, you guys.
You sure it's okay?
Sure.
Don't you regret marrying us a little sometimes?
Never. Maybe around the first of the month.
Mom, look, what are they doing? Come on.
Gareth, give me some air, please. Okay, girls, here we go. All right, give me someone on that fender now.
Careful. Your hangover's showing around the jowls.
Oh, for the blush of youth. You could use a little blush yourself, by the way.
I prefer to pinch them like Scarlett O'Hara. It couldn't be. But of course it could.
Oh, what? Where?
It's Dinah and the baby. Dinah!
Gareth!
Oh, and the baby. Thank God you recognized me. No? Huh? You haven't changed one iota? Oh. I mean, not a soup song. And you? You were just a cuddly little munchkin.
Lori, I'd like you to meet your Uncle Gareth.
Hi.
And
your Uncle Conrad.
Hi.
Are we that old? No.
Yes. Oh, God, what? It's been 10 years? I was an assistant buyer, and you were...
dressing windows.
At Macy.
Connie, look at her eyes. She's you, Dinah.
Mine is the crow's feet.
You're looking terrific.
Oh, yeah, well, I finally gave up my Charles Revson fantasy and accepted my artistic nature.
Okay, that's five, kid. Five, everybody.
I gotta get a picture of this for my memory book. Wait here. Oliver! Shoot. Okay, everybody. Maestro's gonna snap for a snarl. Let's say we cap it up with it, huh? I did the baseball cap. Okay, let's see. Headband for Di. Beret for Connie.
You?
Let's see, for the baby. The hat that made Ally McGraw famous, only in red. Good. Good. Okay, everybody. Say sleeve.
Sleeve!
Taryn Blake. Now, Taryn is a girl who earns $10,000 a day, and you're asking her to work for a week for $2,500? $2,500 is not going to pay for a suite at the Beverly Wilshire. Right. Now, why don't you just get out your little computer, darling, and work it out? Well, of course, I'll talk to her. I'll try. For you, anything. You take care now. Oh, and be careful whose pool you swim in tomorrow. You never know who's been in it yesterday. Hooray for Hollywood! They're dying to have her.
Racine, please. It is absolutely, absolutely out of the question.
Why, though? You know how much I want to be in movies. This is my chance.
Movies? Fine. A guest shot on Fantasy Island? Please. I can't even believe that you would consider it.
Julia, we've considered worse.
Well, not for Taryn.
Right. It was a good shot, but she's got to do Wesley's collection anyway. That's much more important.
It's not important to me. I don't want to do Wesley's dumb collection. I want to be an actress.
You would fall on... you would fail if you tried to be an actress now. That takes years of study. People work years for that.
Well, then let me study.
How would you like to take some classes? I've got connections at the Actors Studio. I'm sure I could get you in. Taryn, darling, why don't you wait outside for a minute, and I will deal with mean old Mom.
Racine, what the hell are you doing to me?
I'm indulging her a little bit, something you might try doing more often.
I'm her mother, you be her agent.
Look, Julia, trust me. I've dealt with the acting bug before. I know what it's like. Once a week, she'll put on a black turtleneck, she'll go off, she'll pretend to be an egg frying in a pan, or a tree growing, or whatever it is those people do, and she'll get it out of her system. You'll see.
We'll see. I guess that's why we've been with you for 14 years.
And it's why you're going to be with me for another 14 years. Because we have created the greatest thing in this business since lip gloss. Nothing's going to change that.
Better get ready.
apologizing for?
For making him look like an idiot. But that's not what you say. You say,
I'm really sorry about the picture, Mr. Miles. I was only kidding, you know. I really didn't mean anything by it.
Your apology's unnecessary, Taryn. Those of us in public eye just have to get used to these things. Don't we? Well, let's get down to business. I want you to look at these sketches.
Oh, gosh.
Now, the overall look we're going for is fresh and young, but with an edge of sophistication. The idea is something soft and feminine.
Yes.
That still makes a statement romantic and full of promise.
It is a wonderful concept, Wesley. There's a huge market out there for this sort of thing, and I love the name.
First love.
What do you think of the name, Taryn?
You mean, do I get it?
Your clothes have always been Taryn's first love.
Please, Julia, I want to know what Taryn thinks.
I think I'm perfect for it, if that's what you mean.
You're a quick study. What do you really think?
I think every woman in the country will want them.
Except you? Is that what you mean?
Well, of course she'd want them. They're just her style.
I don't want style, Julia. I want innocence.
That's just what Taryn is.
Is that so, Taryn?
Wesley, no one's innocent anymore.
Better. Walk proud, shoulders down, head up. No, don't pull that up. No, give me something young and sporty.
For what?
17. Nice. Mademoiselle.
You'll have to imagine the million-dollar outfit, darling.
I'll walk in. It'll be Steve.
I love this city.
Cheers in Stonehurst, Long Island. Where'd you live here?
Well, a village, of course. You should have seen me, sketchbook under my arm. I was going to set the fashion world on fire.
Thanks, honey. Come right in. All right. Thank you. I don't understand. I need a sexy self in this ad, and Messina's sending me a baby. How old is she?
It's Lori Caswell. She's 16. You want to pass?
16.
Her mother's outside. Maybe we should test her. I don't know.
Hold it a minute.
You want to go for it?
Lori, listen, honey, this is what I want you to do. You like cowboy movies, you know, westerns?
You mean like Little House on the Prairie?
Well, no, not exactly. More like,
High Noon with Gary Cooper.
Who?
Never mind, honey. All I want you to do is, I want you to pretend that you are a cowboy and you're walking down Main Street. Can you give me that kind of walk? Here we go. Huh? Here we go. Okay, music.
What?
was terrific. Absolutely terrific. And I love that bit you did with your hat. Put your hand back like that.
Mr. Larner, may I ask you a question?
Shoot.
What am I supposed to be winking at?
All right, now I know it's only 12 degrees, but we're gonna have to make this look like it's springtime. Now work with me, guys. Michelle, get them some ice cubes. I don't want their breath to show.
Charlie? Clean out that stuff there. That's gonna show, all right? Put on that scarf. How you like it?
It's terrific.
Everybody not working. Come on, off to set.
So how old are you anyway?
17.
Hey.
Okay, 16 and a half.
Well, I can see where your daughter gets her looks.
They say each generation surpasses the last.
Look out, she may make you a bundle.
But I'm here just for the money.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You know, it's not the money. It's the amount. Get down, honey. A little more. All right. Now, after all this stuff, let's see what we got here. We gotta have something happen.
Is Larner a family friend?
No, I never saw him before the other day.
Oh, I guess he's just after your mom, then.
Intimate picnic, all right?
What do you mean, after her?
Well, he's got a pretty bad reputation.
Really?
Hey, don't worry. She's a big girl. She can take care of herself. But you better worry about yourself.
Gee, you'd make a ski commercial around here. All right. Now, come on. It's the Garden of Eden at Central Park. That's it. Come on. Laugh, Lori. Come on, laugh. What's he doing?
That tickles.
Oh, yes. Yes, you're enjoying it. Fabulous. That's fabulous. Fabulous. Okay. Nuzzle. Kiss her. Kiss her, kid. Okay, roll the camera.
Langdon Sportswear. Feel the heat.
Can't believe they're giving her commercials so much airtime.
You know, most of these are just fine, Dinah, but I mean, some of them. This one here. I mean, it makes her look like she's 30 years old, you know? I'm not so sure I like that.
No, that's just a test. Baby, they're not gonna use that. They just want to see where they can go with her.
Well, too far, I'd say.
Well, can you finish?
Do you remember the smell of bacon and the sputter of eggs at all?
Yes, well, the frying pan's right over there.
No, that's not what I meant.
Hello? Oh, hello, Rosie.
Ready, Michael?
Want some breakfast?
Nah, I think I'll go without.
Well, I don't know about an exclusive. Isn't it a little soon, Rosie?
I mean, we are talking a major perfume.
Lana's really pushing.
Well, can't you stall him?
Darling, he adores her.
He wants to use her in everything. Get me a coffee, will you, Daddy?
Okay. Alan Larner. I don't know, Racine. I mean, it's all happening so fast.
Caswell's iffy. Who else is available?
What about Alan Lerner? He wants to sign you to an exclusive, but I'm trying to put her off. It's too soon.
Oh, just a minute. Excuse me, just for a second. Hello, Racine.
Yeah, my daughter and I would like to say goodbye to my wife.
Listen, honey, let's see if you can be home later tonight. Don't hold dinner for me. I'm not having an affair. I love you very, very much. Thanks, Racine. She's all yours.
Bye, Mom.
Racine, are you still there?
Yes, darling. I'm always here.
Oh, doesn't it feel weird being recognized?
Oh, come on, she loves it.
It's not such a big deal.
It must be so exciting.
Yeah, well, I guess it is.
More exciting than tonight's game?
Hey, Steve, how you doing?
I'm okay.
Good.
Hiya, Lori.
Hi.
Hey, Lori. How's it going?
Hi. Oh, great, thanks.
You're looking great.
Thanks.
I gotta get to the gym.
Oh, me too.
So, what time should I pick you up tonight?
Oh, Steve, I can't. I've got a 5 o'clock call tomorrow. Sorry. It's the Cougars, too.
Now, that was last week. We won. 84-80. Now, tonight's the Eagles.
Oh.
Look. I mean, give me a call when you get back, okay? I mean, if you want.
What's that supposed to mean? Of course I want. Steve?
Every time I see Taryn, it just confirms what I felt from the beginning. She's wrong. She's totally wrong for the line.
No, I think you're wrong.
Well, of course you do. She's your client.
You're still upset about that picture in the trades.
I'm upset about Taryn. She's been around too long. The freshness that she used to have, the warmth, the genuineness, it's not there anymore, Racine. It's not in that face.
Is it in this one?
Who is she?
No one. Just a silly idea I had.
Who is she?
Her name is Laurie Caswell. I stole her from Zoli.
She's fabulous. She's fabulous.
I told you to hold all my calls. Unfortunately, who've already signed a contract with Taryn. Julie really nailed you on that one.
Julie's. I know how Lizzie Borden must have felt.
Oh, if only we could do it without a trace, I'd join you. Mm. No, that's unkind. Poor Julia. You should have seen her face the day that I first signed Taryn. It was twitching, I swear to you. No, I'm afraid there's nothing we can do. Unless... No, it's unrealistic.
Tell me.
Unless we use them both.
Innocence and experience. Simplicity and sophistication. I can see the cover already. We'll get Oliver to do a double shoot.
Now, don't get carried away. I haven't pulled this one off yet. Besides, Julia could sue.
You tell Julia that if she does not consent to a double shoot, Taryn won't be modeling for me at all.
You want me to run naked through Central Park?
At midnight.
Well, I've always loved a good dare.
Mother, have you gone crazy? Do a double shoot with someone who's never even had a cover? No way. I mean, what have you said about double shoots? That they divide the viewer's attention, that they force a choice. You know, I'm really starting to wonder about you. You turn down a TV show because I'm doing Wesley's stupid collection, and then you make a share credit deal on that.
Are you through?
I will be if you keep managing my career. I bet Wesley only changed his mind because Laurie Caswell doesn't cost as much as me.
Wesley changed his mind because he saw someone he wanted more than you. Do you understand? You'd lost it. He didn't want you. Taryn, oh, you're the best, honey. You are the most beautiful, the most talented girl in the whole world.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. And you will never take second place to anyone, ever, as long as you have me. Look, if they want to force a choice, let them. All eyes will be on you, and they're going to stay on you, because Lauren Caswell is just another pretty teenager. There are hundreds of them out there. They're Cinderella at the ball. It's a fairy tale to her, out of a storybook. But baby, to you, you've been in this business your whole life. We know what it's cost you. You're going to show them all how it's done. You understand? You're gonna put her away.
Makeup will do.
Oh, come on, Angie. She looks great.
Says the star's best friend.
Some friend. We hardly ever see her anymore. She's busy.
Yeah, I'll bet she's busy. With this hunk here. Ooh, he's intense. No wonder she's never around.
Nice, Angie.
Hi. I was just thinking about you.
Sure. Where is everybody?
Oh, who knows? We all seem to be going our separate ways these days.
Sounds familiar. You got any beer?
Beer?
Beer.
I'll look. Just soda. I've really been meaning to call you. Ow! Steve! What are you doing?
What's the matter? High school boy's not good enough for you anymore?
What are you talking about?
I mean, I bet you he's gone a lot farther than I have.
Who? What are you talking about?
This model you're always hanging on to.
I work with Kevin, that's all.
Yeah? Well, you can have your pretty boy, and he can have you. If he's not gay, that is.
I assure you he isn't.
Stein, for the rest of you turkeys, for goodness sake, don't forget to wait for the beep. And, sweet dreams.
I always have sweet dreams.
You want to tell me about nothing?
It's over between me and Steve. He thinks I'm all stuck up.
Oh, sweetie, I'm sorry. Oh, that's terrible. But you know, sometimes when you're growing up, you move away from old friends. I mean, not that it feels...
Hello. Oh, hi, Racine. Yeah, I just got back. No, it went very well. Alan had a wonderful concept about the commercial. What? You're kidding. Oh, no, she'll be thrilled. Can't believe it either. I'll call you tomorrow.
What?
No, you're probably too upset to hear.
Come on, Mom.
Tomorrow morning, we meet with Wesley Miles, who wants you to do a double shoot with Taryn Blake in Hawaii.
I guess I could send Steve a postcard.
Only one.
How come you guys didn't wait?
We waited yesterday, but you never showed up. I guess some people can't be counted on.
I had to go into the city at the last minute. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you and Steve?
Why don't you ask Steve?
Oh, Hawaii! Oh, it says here you're going to Hawaii. When?
Next week for the layout with Taryn.
Oh! Come on, Jen. I want to finish up my drama assignment before class. Hey, do you need somebody to carry your bags? Maybe keep Wesley Miles company?
Jen, you said you'd help.
Okay, Kelly.
Aloha, Lori, dear.
I'll call you tonight, okay?
Hey, it's the new face of the 80s. How you doing, Lori?
You still going with O'Neill?
No. We broke up.
Need a ride home after school? Hey. No big deal, you know, just a ride home.
Hey, Judy, how you doing?
How you
This is ridiculous. Does she realize that she's kept an entire crew waiting here for over an hour?
In a word, yes.
Bear with us, will you guys? We'll be with you in a minute.
It's my fault, isn't it?
Don't be silly.
She doesn't want to work with me, I know it.
Now, will you just calm down, Angel? Everything's gonna be just fine.
Mother, they're waiting.
Darling, they will wait. You just remember everything I told you.
I know, Mother.
Annabelle? You get in that tent and tell Julia Blake if her daughter isn't out here in 2 minutes.
Hello.
Well, no wonder it took her so long to get dressed.
Everybody, shall we begin?
Okay, everybody, let's do it. Come on, Oliver, let's go.
Okay. Can I have the two bathing beauties here together, please? Just relax. You look great.
Good luck, honey.
Okay. Okay, kids, this is the setup. Atmosphere, ladies, give me serene. Atmosphere, looking out. Okay, here we go. Closer together. Good. Okay, give me carefree, hot, but not too obvious. Taryn. Come on, Taryn. Taryn, you're blocking her. Yeah, get in there, Lori. Taryn, come on. I don't like that. Taryn, please, give me a break. Okay, let's try it again, okay? And let's really have some fun, okay?
Ah!
Oh. You okay?
Oops. Sorry.
Cancel the dinner reservations, Gareth. It's gonna be a long day.
Okay, everybody, listen up. I know it's been a long day, but we only have one more shot. Okay, I'm coming down. Hey, hon, would you put the sky filter on for me? Wes, we're gonna make this shot from here. Last roll.
Thought if we try to get them to hold hands, you know, maybe some David Hamilton stuff.
Yeah, I can barely get them to smile.
Try.
Okay. You love each other. You're best friends. You tell each other everything. You wear each other's clothes. Smile. Good. Good, Lori. Okay. Yeah. Good. Good. Okay, come on. Hold hands. Big smiles. Good. Oh, he's a... Hold that. Hold it. Whoa! Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Are you okay, sweetheart? It's all right. Don't worry about it. We got all we needed.
Taryn,
leave me alone.
Julia, I'd like to have a word with you. How could you encourage Taryn to act like that? Well, your daughter is just really darling. It's just she really can't. Well, she doesn't have any... Excuse me.
No. What you did was inexcusable.
Sorry, Taryn.
That's okay.
Oh. Oh. I'm gonna get you. You jerk! You You and your stupid games. Get out!
Oh, you beginner novice.
Comrade Gareth, one of you guys do something.
I'm not going in there.
What are you laughing at?
I'm not cleaning this up.
Oh my God! What have you done? What are you? Come here. Come with me. Look at this place. What are you two up to? Come here.
It's a little heavy on the eyeliner, but otherwise, touché.
They're so expensive. Mom's gonna kill me.
Hi, it's your money, your card.
Have you had a breath?
Have you had a breath too?
You want mine?
Sure.
We can't really go to the party tonight wearing this stuff. We haven't been to one of Oliver's parties. Conrad and Gareth once came dressed as Romeo and Juliet.
They did.
Oh, my God. What?
Look, it's Warren Beatty.
Gorgeous. Let's go talk to him.
Wait. You can't just walk up to him like that. He's famous.
So are we, dummy. Famous people like to be recognized by other famous people. Besides, I met him at a party once. Come on.
Wait, Tara, you can't do this.
Excuse me, do I know you?
Do you remember the last party we had here? That woman came in and she had the wet kimono on.
Oh my God.
No, did she wear that on purpose? Or oh, was that
and
a
she
mis-
was huge? She was huge?
She was so big.
You know, he's got ears. Smile!
Hey, baby, how are you? Come on in.
Now, you're gonna have a bite tonight.
Everybody, right? Everybody, even you.
Connie, you look fabulous. Is that a zit?
Hold it.
It's gonna look like this. Baby in the baby. Lori's sitting in the classroom.
Oh, I see.
Not on the beach.
My guest of honor.
You're right.
See something you like?
Darling, she's just another model.
Annie, let me get one shot.
Besides, she's only 16 years old.
I've seen the look on your face before.
Yeah, when?
The first time you saw me.
If my mom called your mom, you think she'd let you spend the night?
I don't know.
I've never done it before. How long does it take by train?
Only about 45 minutes. And I could pick you up at the station.
Really? Great.
No.
Why not? It's Saturday.
I said no. What did you do, pack a duffel bag?
She invited me to spend the night, too.
Oh. Honey, why don't we do something together? What do you say, just you and me? How about the zoo or the Whitney? Oh, gosh, I know, Radio City Music Hall. And then a late lunch at the Russian Tea Room. What do you say?
I never get to go anywhere unless it's with you. This is the first real friend I've ever had. Someone my own age who I can have fun with.
Don't we have fun, Taryn?
Sometimes.
Lots of times. I know. You've been working hard.
Mother, I want to go to Lori's house. I want to sleep over. I want to do what other kids my age do.
You want to go? Go. Fine. Go. Go be a regular kid.
Mom, it's only overnight.
Don't you like your life, or don't you like me, or both?
Mommy.
Do you think you got to be supermodel Taryn Blake by some kind of a miracle? You think it was always yes, Mrs. Blake? No, Mrs. Blake, of course, Mrs. Blake. When I was your age, I was waiting tables, Taryn. And after your father took off, it was back to the diner so that I could work nights to spend the days with you. You think this was all just luck? I dragged you from go-see to go-see on baby powder commercials and diaper commercials and catalog work, anything I could get, just so that you would eat well and dress well and have a damn tutor and drive around in cabs so that you didn't have to freeze your buns off waiting for a bus. You've never been cold or hungry or afraid that you wouldn't make the rent. And you never will, because I made damn sure you never will.
What's any of this got to do with my going to see Lori?
Because she's using you, don't you see it? I won't let my hard work go down the drain.
Is that what I am to you? Hard work?
You're my life, Taryn. Don't you know that?
Sorry.
You walk out on me. Go ahead. Like father, like daughter.
See you tomorrow. Where'd you learn to ride in the city?
48 takes on a bicycle commercial.
All right, Taryn, go for it.
I've never seen him like this before.
Woo! Oh,
yeah!
Good job!
I do a lot of sporting goods commercials. Where's Taryn Lee?
In the photo booth. I wouldn't bother them if I were you.
Well, it's time to go. Lee. Taryn?
Our turn next.
I don't think 17 will ever print it. They're gonna make one of these things out of me. It's coming out this spring.
Really? A doll of yourself? How weird.
A doll of Taryn Blake, model. Someday I'm gonna be an actress and live in California.
My father lives in California. My real father, I mean.
What's he do?
He makes sculptures out of car parts. Mostly hubcaps. He's really nice, but he doesn't always come through, you know what I mean?
Yeah. My father left when I was 1 year old and hasn't been heard of since. You'd think seeing me splashed all over magazines and everything would bring him out of hiding. Of course, then he'd have to deal with my mother.
She doesn't like me much, your mother.
It's not you. She just doesn't want anything to get in the way of my glorious career. You're lucky your mother isn't always on the phone or making deals and something like that.
Yeah, I guess. I'm sort of sleepy. Let's go to bed, okay? It was good, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Could you imagine if my mother knew I was eating pizza? I think I gained 2 pounds.
Oh my God!
I really like Lee.
I noticed.
He kisses great. But I'm glad we had to leave. Boys always want to go really far right away.
Have you ever?
Haven't you?
Not even with Steve? It's no big deal. He was lots older. I didn't even know what was happening.
Did your mom know?
Are you kidding? She'd kill me. After all, I couldn't do Mademoiselle bookings if I was pregnant, right?
I guess not.
What's it like?
It's like... Well, it's not like it is in the movies, that's for sure. I like kissing best. Anyway, you'll find out soon enough. Lori?
Hmm?
I'm glad I'm here. You're my first best friend. Night.
Night, Tara.
Back with a Blue Plate special movie on Turner South.
I'm Christine.
And I'm Justin.
And we're the Bush.
Hi, Steve.
Well, this Steve? What is it, the 4th of July or something?
Okay, I know. I acted like a baby. But you weren't exactly mature about it either, you know.
I guess. Listen, I'm sorry. Okay?
Do you want to maybe talk about it after school?
Yes.
Hi, Steve. Here's your lunch. You left it in the car. Hi, Lori. How's it going?
Fine, thanks. I'll see you around, Steve. I want to quit school and have a tutor like Taryn.
We'll see, Lori.
I don't want to see. They treat me like I'm a freak. No, they'd be nicer to a freak. It's like I've done something wrong or something.
A lot of the teenage models have tutors. I must say, Taryn's doing awfully well with hers.
But Lori isn't Taryn, and that's just the point. Besides, a tutor would even alienate her even more. It's also pretty expensive.
It's my money.
Lori, listen to me.
I don't have to listen to you. It's got nothing to do with you. You're not even my father.
Might as well hear the rest of it. Wesley Miles has offered us an exclusive contract for 2 years.
And Lori wants to do it.
Well, I haven't told her yet, but I'm sure she'll be thrilled.
Yeah, well, what's the difference? And pretty soon you're going to be making all her decisions for her, just like Julia Blake.
I am nothing like Julia Blake. I'm a damn good mother.
I didn't say you weren't.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying I don't like all the changes around here, for one thing. I don't like the fashion business. And I don't like what it's doing to Lori, and most of all, I don't like what it's doing to us.
What do you expect? You want me to take up needlepoint? She's headed for the top.
That's right. And pretty soon you're going to be right up there with her, aren't you? This thing has taken over our lives. I mean, we've got no time for anything else.
Yeah, like your needs, for instance.
You bet! And Lori's and yours, whether you recognize it or not.
I'm going to rent an apartment in New York. So Lori and I don't have to commute during the week. I'm also going to arrange for a tutor.
No. I'm not going to let you destroy what we have.
Well, then try to understand.
What I understand, Dinah, is that this family is falling apart.
I am not asking for a divorce.
You don't have to.
Steve, yeah, okay. Good. Okay, come down. Beautiful.
motion on that, okay? Kevin, you're on your side. Okay. Lauren, come here, Lloyd. Up. Okay. Put your left foot on his hip. One for me. Yeah, okay. Good. On her ankle, Kevin. Good. Okay. Very good. Kill the playback, baby. Are you all right, kid?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks, Al.
Okay. Just a sec, okay?
What's with her today?
Some of this stuff is a little kinky. I don't know if she's ready for it.
She'll get it. She's dynamite. Hit it, Bob.
Come on, Lori. No, no, no! Just a little more. Come on.
Wait. Wait, Oliver.
Sorry.
Lori, are you okay?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Just have a headache, that's all. Ollie, could we take a break, please, just for a few minutes?
Okay, kill the flames, hold the music. Everybody, on the five.
You just come here. That's all right. That's okay.
Where's Mom?
Oh, it's okay, it's okay.
She's
now, don't you
be back in a few minutes.
Yeah, anybody got an aspirin? Hmm?
How about some nice hot herb tea?
Hmm? She's got a headache, Dr. Kildare.
I'd like to be alone with Lori.
We're right here if you need us.
I'm sorry I'm wasting so much time, really.
Now, don't even think about it. Don't even talk. You just sit and let it all go, okay? You know, I'll cancel the whole shoot if you're not feeling well. What is it? Hmm? You don't like some of the things that Oliver's asking you to do, is that it?
No, no, it's not that. It's just stuff at home.
You sure? Listen, if you ever need anything, you call on me, okay? If you're ever in any trouble or you just need somebody to talk to, okay?
You're really nice to me.
Listen. I care about you a lot. You're my girl, hmm? And don't you forget it.
All right, I'm going to do a little shopping over on Fifth Avenue. I'll meet you at the restaurant at 6 o'clock sharp. Do not be late. Get some good exercise and no junk food.
What do you want first? Potato chips or brownies? Gosh, it's gonna be such a blast to be living in the city.
I guess.
Hey, stop moping about Steve. This city is full of gorgeous men. Besides, Eric can always drive into town.
It's not Steve or Eric.
Hope it isn't Kelly or Jenna after the way they snubbed you. What's wrong?
I think my mom and Michael are splitting up.
Really?
They fight all the time now. I feel like it's my fault, you know? They were doing okay before I started modeling.
It's not your fault. You're 16. They're grown-ups. So-called. They can do what they want about their lives. It's us that get pushed around by them. Just wait till I turn 18.
What then?
I'm going to Hollywood. I'm gonna be in movies, and there is nothing Julia can do to stop me.
Yeah, but what do we do till then?
Hang out. What do you want for dessert?
We can't eat all this.
Sure we can. We'll get so fat, nobody will hire us.
And then they'll all starve to death.
605.
You two must have worked up quite an appetite by now.
You've been very good to me, Alan. And I'm really very fond of you.
I don't want you to be fond of me. I want you to come home with me.
No. I just came here to talk business. That's all I'm interested in.
Do you know what you're going to have? I know what I'm going to have.
We'll be right back.
Seeing isn't always believing. Lars just a creep. Comes on to everyone. Doesn't mean anything.
No champagne?
Here's a little bit of diet soda here if you want.
Oh. I meant for you. You knew they'd be there, didn't you? That's why you made such a big deal about us getting there on time. You set it all up. Who told you, Larner's secretary? Could you do that to Lori? She's never done anything to you.
It's not me I was worried about.
You're jealous. You can't stand to have anyone else close to me, can you?
You seem to have begun studying psychology. There's a chapter you should read, Childish Rebellion.
I hate you. I don't care what you did for me when I was little, but I don't want to be around you anymore.
Where do you want to be instead?
I don't know, but I'll figure out something. I want to live around normal people and have friends and go to school.
What are you going to do? Go out for cheerleader? Or be homecoming queen? Oh, face it, Taryn, there's no place for you but exactly where you are.
That's not true!
Look, you're a multi-million-dollar corporation. You are the most famous 16-year-old person in the world. Like it or not, you're Taryn Blake.
Yes, I am Taryn Blake. And you better keep it in mind, Mother. Because in a couple of years, those checks are going to be coming in my name. And what are you going to do then?
View the park and a fireplace.
Huh.
The agent said there's also one at Park Avenue we should look at, and it's going to be available the first of the month. What do you think?
I don't know. You decide.
Lori. Well?
It's okay.
This is the fourth apartment we've looked at today. It's more for you than it is for me. I'd appreciate a little enthusiasm.
If it's really just for me, then let's just forget it, okay? Why don't you just move in with Larner and get it over with?
I told you, it's not what it seems.
He kissed you! You were holding hands!
It's all part of the business, Larner. You don't understand.
I understand plenty. I already lost one father because of you, and I'm not gonna lose Michael. Can we go right away, please?
Lori!
Thank you.
that, I walked around, but it was pretty creepy.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks. I tried calling Taryn, but then I remembered she was out on a night shoot with Oliver and everybody. I didn't know where else to go. I remembered about what you said, if I needed somebody to talk to. So here I am. I'm sorry you had to pay for the cab. I'll pay you back.
Don't worry about it. You did the right thing in coming here. You're warmer now?
How come marriage is so complicated?
I wouldn't know. I've never been married.
How come?
I just never found the right girl.
You look terrible.
Not so bad. Sweet 16. Does that feel good? Lie down. Now, don't worry. Lie down. Right there. There. Well, that's not so bad, is it? All you need is a little TLC. A little attention. That's what we all need. That's what we don't get enough of. Oh.
Don't!
Stop acting innocent, Lori. You show up here in the middle of the night after coming on to me for months, and what do you expect? A big hug and a good night kiss?
But you said if I ever needed somebody to talk to.
And I meant it. Oh, spare me the theatrics, please. What do you think it is when you put on those clothes and strut around in front of the cameras? Do you think it's some kind of a dress-up game? It's sex, Lori. Sex is the message you put out, and you do it very well, too. You know you do. Now, part of you may be a little girl, but there's another part of you that's a woman who knows damn well what she's doing and loves it.
No, I don't. It's all pretend.
Sure. Pretending not to know what you're doing, it's a very good game, Lori. It's like the clothes. Innocent and seductive.
That's not true!
If you want to look like a grown-up, you're going to have to act like one, at least if you want to work for me. This is Mr. Miles. Have a cab downstairs in 5 minutes. Wash your face and take a cab. You know the way out.
Take it easy, okay?
I need to talk to you, Michael. But just you, okay? Can you come pick me up?
You know the coffee shop across from the agency? Yeah, it's open all night. I'll meet you there in 45 minutes.
Okay.
Great.
Do it anymore.
All right.
It's like everything has happened to somebody else. I mean, it was me, but it wasn't me. Do you understand? It's not the work I hate. It's everything else. It's you and Mom not getting along and losing my friends and Steve and just everything else.
Sweetheart. What everything else?
It's just all of it. It's what Wesley said.
Wesley, when'd you see Wesley?
Tonight. I didn't know where else to go.
I didn't know what to do.
More coffee?
No, no, thanks. Sweetheart, I don't understand. What happened?
Wesley wanted me to...
What?
It's more than that. He said I wanted it too. He said that's what I'm doing. He said that I make people think that. And it's...
Lori. Did he hurt you?
Nothing happened, really. Oh, Michael, what am I gonna do? They're signing the contracts this morning.
Don't worry.
Speak to me, Racine.
Stop worrying about it, Dinah. I've been watching mothers and daughters fight for years. Frankly, that's why I never even considered having one myself. Thank you, Phoebe. Ah, come on. This is a celebration. You can't sign contracts on an empty stomach. Besides, it's never too early for champagne.
Good morning.
Good
morning.
Good morning, Wesley. Oh, you look a little ragged this morning.
I didn't sleep well.
Have a bagel.
Just coffee. I've overbooked my morning. Where's the pen? Let's get this over with.
Well, I suppose some of us just aren't morning people.
Maybe we should wait. I mean, shouldn't Laurie sign this too?
Oh, no, that's not necessary. You're her legal guardian.
Yes, but she's the one that takes the brunt of it. And I don't think this is working out as we had planned.
You do whatever makes you happy. I'll talk to you later, Racine.
Excuse me, you're Wesley, aren't you?
Yeah.
You touch my daughter again and I'll kill you.
Michael, what happened?
What happened? What happens when men look at pictures like this, Dinah? This isn't a woman, this is our little girl. Oh, this thing is over with. I'm putting a stop to it right now.
Laurie, I had no idea.
Now, I'm gonna take Laurie home. And you can come if you want to.
Serves us right for dealing with civilians. You know, Wes, last week I came across this girl who makes Laurie, whatever her name is, look like yesterday's news.
I'll wash if you'll try. How did I get so far away?
Opportunity knock.
What did I expect to find?
I don't know. If you'd been really happy with the way things were, I don't think you would have thought about leaving. We've got some things to work out, you and me.
Oh, I know. I don't want to make it work. Because I love you so much.
You know, just now in the car. I know you'd forgive me.
But will Laurie?
I'm back. For good?
What can I say, Laurie, except that I blew it? As I watched all this terrific stuff happening for you, I saw some things that I wanted too. Things that I thought I had given up wanting long ago. And I guess I got carried away. And that wouldn't have been so bad except that it blinded me to you. Anyway, for what it's worth, I'm very embarrassed and I'm very, very sorry. Not so much because I thought only of myself, but because I already had everything that I ever wanted. I'll be downstairs if you want to talk.
Mom!
I can tell. Hey, look, I gotta run. You stick around, okay?
Okay. Hi, Mrs. Blake. Hey, you two still here?
Whoa!
Fashions come, fashions go, we remain.
Karen.
How are you?
Okay.
Taryn, this is Steve. Taryn?
Hi.
Hi.
Told you I'd be here.
People don't always do it, they say.
It's freezing. Mother, can you get me some tea?
Sure, honey. How's Milan? Said you'd write.
I didn't have time to breathe. All the top designers, Adolfo, Valentino, Armani. Conrad, my earring's stuck in the lining.
I thought maybe you'd want to spend the night Friday.
Oh, I can't. I'm going to L.A. Racine got me a movie deal.
Really? That's great.
Taryn! Taryn, we're ready to go, baby.
Okay.
You look sensational. Come on, we're losing the light.
Listen, Laurie, stick around. Maybe we'll talk between setups.
Oh, I can't. We're meeting Michael and Mom in the village for lunch. We just came in for the day. I'll call you tonight, okay?
I'm going out. Probably won't be back till late. I'll call you when I get back from the coast. We'll have lunch.
Sure. Well, I guess I'll see you around.
Yeah.
Okay, Taryn. Warren Beatty is chasing you all over the world. London, Paris, Rome. No matter where you go, he follows you. DeGarbo and Anna Karenina.
She works magic with her eyes. Full of innocence that mesmerizes. Standing before the camera, she smiles a woman's smile. But under the makeup, there hides a child. Oh, baby doll.
Today in the Southland, the bright and the beautiful battle it out for the chance to represent the Tar Heel State in the Miss America contest. The 68th annual Miss North Carolina pageant begins today in Raleigh. Right now, stick around for Glamour with a Hammer. Homemakers is next on Turner South.